I've been told that I don't need a burner because I can use the kettle to boil my pasta. Hi guys, hello from this beautiful house on the lake, which unfortunately I'm about to leave. I look for a new place in Amsterdam for 4 months. It has been exhausting, it has been depressing, it has been really frustrating, but I made it. So finally I can laugh with you about the whole house hunting in Amsterdam experience. I knew that finding a place in Amsterdam would have been challenging, but I want to stay positive and to start this journey full of enthusiasm. So I made a poster listing all requirements of my perfect house, and I even had a couple of pictures as example of how trendy it should have been. Then I set up my patio, I pour a glass of wine, and I waited for the perfect house to manifest itself. But what I got, actually, were just pictures of old birds sending nudes. So I start looking online. Every time I log into Facebook, I was submerged by dozens of ads. Usually, it was the same person posting the same ad across all the groups that I've joined. And usually, it was someone looking for a room, not someone offering one. More ads were from people subletting the room for a short period, like, I will be at the supermarket tomorrow from 5 to 6. Do you wanna take over my room? Registration is not possible because it's a short-time rent. The golden rule of the Amsterdam market is that you have to reply within 20 minutes or the room is gone. So when a decent ad did pop up, I had to drop whatever I was doing, including sleeping, and apply for the room. And that's it, that's all I did most of the time because I rarely got any reply back. The few viewings I got invited to went on as job interviews, but also with some trait of a first date. You know, when you pretend to feel confident and you're all smiley, but all you want to do is go back into your bed and sleep the day away. The discomfort is different though, depending on who is showing the house, and so if it's an agency or if you're meeting your future roommates in the flesh. And by the way, why are they called roommates if you're not gonna share the room? The agency will scan your profile until the very least part of you will feel violated. They will ask for your job contract, which must be full-time and at least 3-4 times the rent, pay sheet, a statement from your bank, reference letters both from your current landlord and your employer, and I'm sure they will also ask for a blood test to check if you use drugs, if only the Dutch health system weren't so tied with costs. If you're meeting your potential roommates instead, it's a whole different kind of flattering. I've seen people showing up to viewings with a bottle of wine, a box of chocolate, some weed. It all depends on the kind of person you're gonna meet. You would expect such coveted houses are penthouses on the canal, but all I got the privilege to see with my budget are just the most creative house arrangement in the city, like shower in the bedroom, shower in the kitchen, a single tube coming from the sink and hovering over the toilet, which they still call shower, or bathroom outside the apartment, meaning that you have to wear your coat and take the key of the house when you have to go to the loo. And then when you have to come back to your bed, you know, half sleepy, you have to climb all your way back there on Dutch typical staircase that are literally like this. And I step into kitchens where the only tool to cook was a microwave, which can be enough for Dutch cuisine, but I'm Italian, come on. Although out of hundreds of applications, only 10-15 people will be invited to the viewing, this small group still feels a big crowd because, you know, only one person will eventually get the room. But this is when the typical traits of a Dutch apartment will come handy. Now you can push the competition down to the steep Dutch staircase. You can hit them on the head with the disposable burner, which they call kitchen. Or you can strangle them with that ubiquitous tube, which you'll keep finding in every room, and they call shower. And if you're viewing an apartment next to a construction site, which is often the case in Amsterdam, it won't even be difficult to hide a body. And now let's get serious for a second, because I want to do a funny video, but there are things that aren't fun at all. I've seen many posts of girls looking for a room, and so posting a photo of themselves to introduce themselves, and then receiving all kinds of comments like, hey, with those boobs you don't even have to pay the rent. Seriously, this is unacceptable. We should all report those ads to Facebook. Let's fight this battle together, and happy hunting!